Okay, this is Maya. We've got Dawn here handling her, and she brought her from Southern Indiana. So Dawn's going to tell you a little bit about her story while I get something to reward her with for being a good girl.
Maya is 8 years old, and she has kind of a sad story. I mean, a lot of them do, but hers is pretty sad. She lived with a guy and her 17-year-old best friend, who was a Shepherd Husky mix, and she'd been with him since she was just a tiny puppy. And the gentleman got evicted from his home and ended up living in his car. So he was living in his car all spring, I think since maybe March or February or something, with Maya and her buddy in the car. And he was trying to find more housing and wasn't able to do that. And so when it started getting, luckily it was a cool spring and he was able to keep them with him. But when then it started to get hot outside, and the dogs were really suffering in the car. So he had no way to provide anything else for them. So he surrendered them to the local Humane Society down in Evansville. And they contacted me about her. The 17-year-old, sadly, was in really bad shape and had to be euthanized. But they said, you know, we've got her. She's in great shape. Would you consider her? And I visited and just fell in love with her. She's as sweet as can be. Great temperament. Loves people. Loves other dogs.
How was she in the car when you brought her up?
She was so good in the car. She's just really, really good. Well, she lived in the car.
Yeah. That's true.
So it was just kind of rolling at this point. But anyway, so she is really a sweet dog. I mean, for somebody that wants a nice, quieter dog that's a little older and can adapt and a great chance at a second home for her. She had a lot of love. She's not a dog that
it's clear for him to have gone that, you know, so many people at the first sight of misfortune dump him at the shelter. And I mean, he really stuck by her.
Well, he tried to find something else for them and was not able to. And sadly, she's kind of a victim of the economy, I think, like a lot of people. And
we'll
find her a great second home and for her to spend the rest of her time. And just like I said, she loves people, loves other dogs.
Yeah, he said he's had her out with the other dogs, and she was kind of shy at first, but has had no issues at all. I did see her with a little bouncy dog. Kind of just say, hey, she just kind of very gently put her neck there and kind of like settle down, little one, and very gently. And Dolly, who was bouncing off the walls, was real good about that. So,
well, and I will mention that this shelter does a pretty extensive temperament testing, and she came through that just great. I mean,
perfect.
They didn't have any problems with her. She came through that screening very, very well. So I think she'll be a really nice. Yes, I'm talking about
she said,
you.
I need a home. She needs to be brushed really badly. We are gonna do a little grooming party on Saturday. So she said, normally when I've got my hair combed, I look a lot better.
She's a pretty girl.
But who among us older women don't look better when we've got our hair combed? So how about that? The young women too, by the way.
Yes,
she's a good girl. Do we know about cats and small? Was she? She was no cats, wasn't she?
She was no cats and small dogs.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Actually, I'm not sure about small dogs. She's no cats, I think.
Okay.
We'd have to check on small dogs. And you know, since I do adoptions, I will check on small dogs for her, for if somebody is interested and has small dogs.
Okay. Okay. So. It seems like she knew something the other day. She's just all distracted. She's like, I'm inside. People are petting me. But she's such a pretty girl. She's such a pretty girl. Look at that sweet face. Do you know Shake? No. Okay. Nope.
She's
or
not,
not,
no
right, not right now. Yeah, she's like, there's the guy that feeds me. Yeah. They all get distracted.
If Chad comes in, they're like, food? Maybe something to eat?
Hey, sweetie. Hey, sweetie. And very alert. I mean, she does not act like a senior dog at all, except for the more mellow component. So.
Right.
So there she is.
She said, I wasn't senior compared to my 17-year-old friend.
I was the spring chicken. Yeah, absolutely. Well, an eight, that's, you know, I don't consider an 8-year-old husky a senior.
No.
I think I'm pet finder.
They just start to slow down at that point.
Yeah.
They're not really.
So. And especially since she's been well cared for.
Mm-hmm.
And. Yes, yes.